In this tutorial, we're going to explore the tool Testmoz. Testmoz is an online assessment tool which you can use with your students for grading them for their revision tests, unit tests, quizzes, or any other test that you wish to take with your students. Now, taking regular quizzes and tests will build engagement with your students. So, do try this app out. Now, let me tell you the best part about using this tool is that you don't even have to check the answers yourself. Testmoz will do it for you. There are two versions of Testmoz. One is a free version and one is a paid version. In this tutorial, I'll take you through the features of the free version. So let's begin this tutorial. In my browser, I have only typed testmoz.com to reach this page. Now here I'm going to go to build a test. Remember, this is a free version, so a lot of features will not be available in the free version. Let's look at some features and warnings that are given here. Limitations: you can build a test for free on Testmoz, but remember these limits: 50 questions per test and 100 responses. So you can send it to 100 students with a limit of 50 questions, and I think that is pretty great. Or you can also sign up to Testmoz to remove these limitations. But right now, as I told you, in this tutorial, we are going to go through only the free version. Let's look at the warning that's given to us. Don't forget your password. You cannot recover it. Don't forget your test URL. You'll see it on the next page, which I will take you through really soon. Now, we are going to give the name of our test, Chapter 2, Universe. I'm going to choose a password, say universe123. Now, since it asked me not to forget the password, and this is what I do for all my Testmoz tests, is I have an Excel file where I keep a note of all the tests that I've created. So I'm just going to type it out, the test password, universe123. I'm going to type the chapter name, I mean the test name, universe. Now the link we are going to get on the next page, so I'm going to go back to my test and I'm going to do create test. So this will lead you to the chapter 2 universe dashboard. Here is where you can see every setting of the test. I'm going to take you through the first step, that is adjusting the settings. But before I do that, can we see the step 0? It is absolutely critical that you do this. That is, bookmark this page and write down your password. So I can bookmark my page using this star icon. But what I do instead is I copy my link. And like I told you, in my Excel, I just paste the link so I never have to forget my link and the password. I'm just going to go back to my tab and I'm going to do adjust settings. Now this is going to take me to the second step, that is the setting step. So this will be the settings for all of my questions that is coming in the chapter 2. Let's look at each one of them. This text is displayed on top of the test. You can use this to write your instructions. So I'm just going to say, you can choose a color scheme, but I'm just going with the basic. Now question settings. Show all test questions on one page, which I like because I want my students to see all the questions on the same page. And randomize the order of the questions during the test. You can switch this off, which will show all the questions only in a specific order. But I like to keep this on because if my students are discussing the questions with each other at different points, so I like to keep the order random so they will not be able to know. Now this is the ending text, that is the conclusion text, what will appear to the students after they have submitted the text. But what I like to do is I like to show a custom message to my students. So I'll set a passing score that is 60%. And the pass message is well done. And if the student fails, the message is. And at the end of the test, what can the students see? The score, the test outline. That is, indicate if the response was correct or incorrect. Display the correct answer. I'm going to close these two options because there is a possibility that my students are taking the test at different times and I don't want them to call each other and discuss the correct answer. So I'm just going to close that option. Now, who can take this test? I'm going to say anyone with a passcode can take the test, and the passcode that I will keep is say 7B2020. And what should the test takers enter to identify themselves? So I'm going to say enter your full name. I can also set a time limit on my test, but I don't want to do that. How many times can someone take your test? I'm going to keep this as one time, because I don't want my students to keep opening the test over and over again and retaking it. Now, these are some other functions that I'm just going to skip right now. And notifications, this is important. Do you want to receive an email whenever someone finishes the test? Since I have a lot of students taking this test, I would like to keep this feature off. And that brings me to the end of the settings. We will go over the questions tab next. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please watch the next one to understand how to build the questions.